On the Oculus Go, have you tried downloading Netflix content to watch offline? If you did, then just like me, you probably have noticed that this does not work, annoyingly. But I have found a way to do this by sideloading the standard Android app on the Oculus Go, and I will show you in this video how to do this exactly. Coming up now.
So in this video, I will tell you how to sideload apps to Oculus Go. And more specifically, I will sideload the standard Netflix Android app, because that version allows you to watch Netflix content offline like you can on your phone. But if you want to sideload any other app, you can do that as well with this guide. If you already know how to sideload APK on Oculus Go and only want to know how to watch Netflix content offline, then skip to
around 7 minutes.
Let me explain quickly what sideloading does, just in case you don't know what it is. By sideloading APK, you essentially get access to games and apps that aren't in the Oculus store yet. Since the Oculus software is also built on Android, you can download any Android game or app and install it on your Go. Be aware though that those apps are not always built for the Go, so it might not always work. Okay, to get you started, you need to do the following. First of all, create an Oculus developer account. Go to the Oculus website, link is down below, and sign into your Oculus account. Make sure it is the account that you use for your Oculus Go 2. Create a name for your organization, doesn't matter what you call it. If you agree to the terms, check the box and press I agree. Now turn on developer mode in the Oculus Go app on your phone. Open the app, click on your Oculus Go, more settings, developer mode, and then toggle developer mode on. If you cannot turn on developer mode here, then you should double check if you use the right Oculus account to create an organization in the first step of this guide. If you have an Android phone, the settings could be located somewhere else, but I trust in you guys to be able to find it. Download the SDK platform tools from the Android developers website, which I already opened here. You can find the link down below as well. Just click on SDK platform tools for Windows, if you have Windows, and if you agree to these terms, just checkmark this, click on download, wait until it's finished. Once it's finished, just open the map, unzip it, and now copy this folder and place it anywhere you want. I placed it in my C dev Android folder, as you can see here. Now you have to add the path of this folder to your environment variable. So I'm going to copy this path here. I'm going to my environment variables. In Windows 10, you can just type into Windows search environment variables and it will show up here. Click on it. Click on environment variables. Now find your path here. Double click it. Click on new and paste your path here. Click OK and another OK and another one. Now we are going to test if this works. So we are going to the command prompt. In Windows 10, just click on your start button, type in CMD. Make sure you open command prompt as administrator by right clicking it, run as administrator, click yes. Now type in ADB help. And if you see this, it means it works and you have successfully installed ADB. So if this doesn't work and you see ADB is not recognized as a command, then you have to check your environment variables. Or you can navigate to your installation folder of ADB in command prompt and run the adb.x there. I'll show you that quickly in command prompt. If you navigate to the folder where you put your platform tools, which I've already done here, and just launch ADB by typing adb.x and help, you'll see it works that way as well. Now install the Oculus ADB drivers from the Oculus websites, which you can also find down below. Make sure though that you have version 2.0 here. Click on I agree, download. Wait until it's finished, go to the download folder and unzip this as well. Now just go inside the folder and right click on this inf file and click on install. It will say the operation completed successfully and you're finished. Yes, you are now ready to install APKs. Just connect your baby Oculus Go with a USB cable to your computer. Now open command prompt again and don't forget to open it as administrator and type in ADB devices. Now, if you see this, this means it recognized your Oculus Go and you can start installing APKs. If you don't see a device here, you have to either restart your Go and replug it to your PC or I also have another quick tip. I actually had trouble getting ADB to recognize my device even after restarting, and it was because I had an older version of ADB installed. If you type ADB help and scroll up, you'll see what version you have. And I have this version now, 1.0.40. And this version works. So if you downloaded ADB by going to the official Android developer website that I linked below, then you already have the latest version and it should work. If you run ADB devices and you see unauthorized here behind the device, then you have to put on your Go and use your controller to click accept first, and then it will be able to go inside your Oculus Go. Now I'm going to install the standard Android Netflix app APK. Sorry guys, I don't think I can tell you where I got the APK from, but I'm pretty sure a little Google search will get you far. Once you have it, make sure you navigate to the folder where you downloaded it. I have it here. And now just install the Netflix APK with this command, ADB install. And this is my APK file. Just press enter. Now you have to wait a bit, and once installed, you will see the message success. This means it has successfully installed on your Oculus Go. Now, normally after installing an APK, you can launch it by putting on your Oculus Go. Then go to Library, Unknown Sources, and the installed APK will load in this list. Just click on it to load the sideloaded app. I said normally because compatible APKs will load in this list. The bad news is that Netflix isn't one of those compatible apps for the Go straight away. No worries though, because we will make this work in a different way using Oculus TV. The good news is that you can now sideload any APK by just running the ADB install command, and compatible ones will show up in your unknown sources list. Also, now you have all this set up already, you don't have to set it up again. I mean, that's nice, right? By the way, big shout out to headcheck.io since their article helped me a ton getting this working. I'll link their article down below. But let's move on to the last step of getting Netflix working now. So if you have an app that doesn't show up in unknown sources, you can try opening it in Oculus TV with a command in ADB. To launch Netflix, an awesome person on Reddit, Juggernaut, has made an Oculus TV launcher. So the last step is to install Oculus TV and Juggernaut's Oculus TV launcher to make it work offline too. So install Oculus TV if you haven't, it's a free app in the Oculus Store. Now download the Oculus TV launcher that Juggernaut made. A quick shout out to Juggernaut for making this launcher, by the way. Thank you so much, I think it is awesome work. So, with your Oculus still plugged in, install his APK like we did before by running the command ADB install Oculus V launcher. Yes, I already have it. Press enter. And it is installed. Now you can launch the Oculus TV Netflix by going in Oculus Go, Library, Unknown Sources, and click the launcher. The standard Android Netflix app will open now, where you can watch downloaded content from Netflix offline, so without an internet connection. And that's it, everyone.
Alright, I hope you found this video helpful in any way at all. If you have any questions about the sideloading or just want to let me know what you think of this video, let me know down below, because I would love to hear from you and I will always answer you guys. One special thanks to our patrons for always being there for us. Thank you guys so much. And if you want to explore more VR like these kind of videos with us, be sure to subscribe, especially if you're new here and you like our videos. Well, we are Cas and Chary VR, and I'm Cas, and we always say VR on!